If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in GATE EM theory series. So today again, we will be solving 5 questions starting from question number 36 to up to question number 40. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions. Okay, student, if you come to question number 36, what they are asking, consider a solid sphere of radius this much, 5 cm, made of a perfect electric conductor. 1 million electrons are added to the sphere. These electrons will distribute itself uniformly over the entire volume over the surface. Now, if it is an electric conductor, proper electric conductor, you know, inside the conductor there should be no electric field, because if you move along there is no potential drop. Suppose you come to surface, because it is of electric conductor, so if you move along this surface there should not be any drop. That means in this because you are moving in this direction, there is no change in potential. That means your electric field is outside this side, so there is no electric field in this direction. So the field is in this direction. So you are moving at 90 degree to that one. That means no change. So your E is coming normally out of this one. Okay. So in every place it should be like this. Okay. And inside, if you come inside, then also there should be no change in potential. Now inside you can come from any direction to any direction. You can come this side, you can come this side. So that means there should not be any 90 degree component to this one. That means E cannot exist there. So inside an inductor, E should be equal to zero electric field. So the charge will place them in such a way symmetrically so that it happens, and in the sphere also, outer periphery also, it should come out, the electric field, and inside it is zero. Okay, so if you place uniformly over this surface, then if you move along this surface, suppose if I placed it uniformly over this entire surface. Now if I come up to this, what is the flux containing? So as per Gauss law, it is the charge enclosed. So charge enclosed will be this much. If you come here, the charge enclosed is more. So electric flux is more. That means E will be changing. So which is not possible. That means it cannot be in the E. Yeah, it cannot be uniformly distributed, because E is existing, because the charge enclosed is changing. So the charge should be placed uniformly over the surface. If it is placed uniformly, then this phenomena is true. You can see, if you come inside, what is the flux coming out? The charge enclosed is zero. So zero. So electric field is zero. So if you come here, what is the charge enclosed? Zero. If you come here, what is the charge enclosed? This, and electric field is coming out of that. That is okay. So inside that it is zero. Outside also it is coming out, because all are symmetrically placed. If you take one this side, one this side, one this side, suppose one this side. So if you calculate the field, electric field due to this on this, it will be this side, it will be this side. Suppose if I take, and it will be, if you take all this vector component, all will come this side, because these will get cancelled out symmetrically. If you take all horizontal, one is this side, one is this side, one is this. If you add these three, you will get electric field out of this direction. So it will place symmetrically on the surface. That means it will place uniformly over the entire, over the outer surface of the sphere. That is your option B. Okay, now if you come to 37, what they are asking, consider an electron, neutron, proton initially at rest, placed in a straight line such that the neutron is exactly at the center of the line joining electron and proton. At t equal to 0, they are all released but are constrained to move along the same straight line. Which of these will collide first? So neutral is in between, then here is proton, then there is electron. They can move along this straight line. So this is positive, this is negative, and this is neutrally charged. So positive will come this side, negative will come this side, because they will attract these two, and it will not move. So both will, P will come this side, E will come this side. So here, while going this side, they will strike neutron. And now the question is, which one will be fast? Now you know what is the mass of this electron. Mass of the electron is very less than A. Because it is less than A, so your inertia will be less, so its acceleration will be high. The acceleration of electron will be high. Because its acceleration will be high, so it will come and first strike and neutral. That means your electrons, all particles will never, all particles, proton and neutron, electron and neutron. So electron will first come and strike neutron, because neutron is coming in the way of that one. Because electron mass is less, so its acceleration will be very high. Its inertia will be less, so it will move fast and it will strike it. Force is same. Force on both these are same, because it is less mass, so it will move fast. Now if you come to 38, a thin soap bubble of radius 8 cm, this one, and a thickness of 3.3 micromillimeter, this one, this thickness, the 3.3 micro, is at a potential of 1 volt with respect to the reference point at infinity. The bubble blasts and becomes a single spherical drop, this one, assuming the soap contained all the soap contained in the soap of radius r. So this is small radius r. The volume of the soap in the thin bubble is this one, and that of soap is this one. Drop is this one, small drop. The potential in the potential in volts of the resulting single spherical drop with respect to the same point infinity, what it will be, give it in two decimal place. Okay, so the charge contained will remain same, charge will not get dissipated. So the charge that is accumulated here will remain same here. So if I can find capacitance, then charge capacitance, I can find out the voltage. So how to calculate the charge? I know the voltage of this one. Voltage is given 1 volt. If voltage is given, then Q can be found by, if I know C. So Q equal to CV. Okay. So for the first case, this is the first case. Q equal to CV. V is 1. What is C? Because it is spherical. So it is 4 pi epsilon 0 capital R. So it is 4 pi epsilon 0 capital R. So this is the initial charge of this one, 4 pi epsilon 0. So the charge here will remain same. So here also it will be 4 pi epsilon 0 into capital R. Now here is equal to, this is final equal to C final into V final. Okay. Now what is the capacitance here? Here it is 4 pi epsilon small r into V final. We need V final. So your V final is nothing but capital R by small r. Now you have to calculate what is capital R by small r. Now you can see the volume also remains same. Whatever the soap contained is there, the same volume will be there. Because inside it was here, that is blast, but you find the what is the volume. So volume they have given, the volume of the soap, what is the content in that, same content is there. That is, volume is given 4 pi r square a. So your 4 pi r square a is equal to, what is the volume of this one? 4 by 3 pi small r cube. So its capital R is given, small a is given, everything is given. If you calculate r from there, you will find it is, you will find 0.099 centimeter. So once you know this one, you can apply it here. It is 1 centimeter, it is 0.099. Or you can go to meter also, into 10 to the minus 2, 1 into 10 to the minus 2. Then the answer is 10.03 volt. Now if you come to 39, the capacitance of an air filled parallel plate capacitor is 60. And the dielectric slab whose thickness is half the distance between the plates is placed in one of the plates covering it entirely, then the capacitance becomes 86, neglecting fringing effect, the relative permittivity. So these type of questions are again very common questions you can see. So half of its field, dielectric of whose thickness is half the distance between the plates. So if the distance is this, so it is half, and it is placed so that it is entirely covering one plate. So it is completely connected with the one plate. So this is the capacitance. What is initial capacitance? That is 60 picofarad, which was nothing but epsilon 0 A by D. Now there are two capacitors, C1, C2, both are connected in series. So C1 is now again epsilon 0 A by D by 2. Area is, plate area is remaining same. These are the area of the plate. This is 3D. These are the area plates. So plate area remains same, only distance changes. So it is D by 2. So you can calculate it will be double of this one, 120 picofarad. What will be C2? It is epsilon R, epsilon naught A by D by 2. So this much is 120, so 120 into epsilon r. That is our requirement. Okay, so what will be the C1, C2? If you connected in series, they will be C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. And that they have given is new capacitance is given 86. So I am going everything on pico, so I am eliminating pico now because this set is also pico. So 120 into 120 epsilon naught divided by 120 plus 120 epsilon naught is equal to 86. So if you solve it, you will find your epsilon r is equal to 2.53. Now if you come to 40, positive charge of 1 nanocoulomb is placed in this where all dimensions are in meter. Consider xy plane to be a conducting ground plane. Again, this type of questions also you have solved. This is suppose x, this is y. So this is your grounding plate, this plate. Suppose this is grounding, this is your z axis. So it is placed at 002. So 00.2. Where all dimensions are, consider the xy plane to be conducting, this is properly conducting. Take epsilon naught equal to, find the z component of electric field at 00.1. Here you have to find 00.1. So this is one charge is there, Q. Now because it is a conducting plate, you know there is a image charge should be there. To make, because this conduct you have, if you move along this path, there should be no voltage drop, so your E should be coming out of this. To make it happen, there should be another this one. Otherwise, if you go this side, your Q will be this side, electric field will be this side. This will not, this electric field will come, but I don't want to have any component of electric field in this direction. So to nullify that one, one Q will come from this, Q will pull it from this side, so ultimately you will get electric field coming out of it. Okay, so here you can see it should be coming out of this in the z-axis. So the z component they are asking, so here only they will have only z component only, because it is on the same line. So it is also pushed it in this direction, this electric field will come this direction, and due to it, it also pull it in this. So net electric field will be negative. So answer is negative, that is for sure, that is either B or D. So if I try one by one, suppose this is Q1, this is minus Q. So your electric field due to Q will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 into 10 to the power minus 9 divided by what is this R square, that gap is 0.1, from here to here it is 0.1, 0.2 minus 0.1. 0.1 square into what is this direction, minus k cap, because it is negative direction. What is e minus q? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now if you are putting minus there, that depends. Now if you are putting minus here, because if you put minus, then don't put that negative sign, otherwise it will make contradiction. So you have to put very careful. If you are putting 1 nanocoulomb here, suppose 1 nanocoulomb, then don't give signs of Q. This is now point, this is 0.2 because it is image, so 0.2 plus 0.3 whole square. And now if you put it is minus K, because you know it is coming down, minus K, so no need to put that sign there, that is minus. So otherwise it will be plus, it will go up. So you have to be very careful, ultimately it should come minus. So if you add these two, what will be net electric field, EQ plus EQ minus Q. So minus will be taken outside, 1 into 10 to the power minus 9 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, and this side it will be 1 by 0.1 square, and this side 1 by 0.3 square. So if you add ultimately these two, you will get around 999. Exactly it will not be, or you can depends on how you are putting it, pi epsilon naught. It is 8.85. if you put, you will find around this with a negative sign. So this is your answer. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.